Today we're on the southern part of the Cape Peninsula, and one of the characteristics of this area is that huge amounts of kelp actually wash up on all these beaches. On this particular beach we've actually done some measurements of this, and there's over 1,000 kilograms per year of kelp that is washed up on each meter length of beach. So it's a huge amount of material, and you can see it lying around me in piles here. On the more popular parts of the beaches, the municipality actually comes in and removes this horrible smelly stuff, and that's pretty expensive for ratepayers. But on more remote beaches like this one, it's actually animal garbage collectors that remove the kelp. So if there are no more storms and we come back to this site in just maybe 2 weeks' time, all this kelp behind me will be gone. It will have been removed by air-breathing crustaceans in enormous numbers here. You don't see them all that often though, because they're nocturnal animals. But to see them now, what we have to do is actually pick up some of this kelp, and they'll be having their little snooze underneath the kelp, waiting for the sun to set and the work time to start.
I think one just jumped in my shoe.
Yeah. Sometimes when you're walking on the beach, you'll see these little burrows, these little molehills on the sand, and these are the beach hoppers that are burrowed during the day. The kelp hoppers, which are the garbage collectors on this beach, are nocturnal animals. They're nocturnal air-breathing animals, in fact. So that if they get washed into the sea, they're actually going to drown. So they move up above the high water mark and hide during the day. And then when it gets dark, they emerge and hop clumsily down the beach and start feeding on the newly washed up kelp. So during the day here now, we're going to find them underneath the kelp. So I'm going to lift up some of these big pieces of kelp, and there you can see them nicely here. Thousands and thousands of them under the kelp.
Wow, they're just hopping all over the place.
All hopping all over the place. They hop very clumsily like fleas, so there's no direction in the hop. They just hop up into the air and they fall sometimes upside down, sometimes on their sides, and then they stumble to their feet again and set off. Look at them here.
Boing, boing, boing. Ew. I think you need to go wash your hands.
Okay, I mean, let's get serious here, okay?
Okay. Oh no! What is he doing? Go wash yourself, Charles. Go wash yourself. Night has fallen on the shore. Let's go find our hoppy little friends.
So here we are now in the night. It's between 9 and 10 p.m. and the amphipods have all emerged from their holes further up on the seashore, and they've migrated down where the wet kelp has just been washed up, and they're busy eating away. There's a whole lot of adults and a very large number of juveniles. So obviously we're in the middle of the breeding season here. So amphipods are live bearers. They lay their eggs into a brood pouch between the legs of the female, and their eggs develop there into fully developed little hoppers, which then emerge and just hop away.
They must have like hundreds of them to they have such huge numbers.
50 to 150 babies at
for
a time.
For each brood,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, yeah. So they breed up very, very quickly.
They also, I mean, they're eating this kelp at such a rate, they must have quite strong little mandibles which they're consuming
yes.
it with.
They eat away the fronds and the stipes of the kelp, and the only piece that is left behind is the holdfast, the roots, which seem to be very tough, and they're unable to digest that. So this will turn itself into a little pile of dried holdfasts within a week or two.
What a great job, just cleaning up the beach.
No, they're fantastic, and they're free. So they're individual kelps which seem to be just at the right stage of maturity, nice and ripe, soft but not too rotten, that are attracting the hoppers. So here's one over here which is completely covered, and all the ones around it are actually have very few hoppers on.
So it's like they so like they wait a little
for
bit rotten.
You know, the right stage of maturity of their stake before yeah. they before they tuck into it.
It's like it softens up a little bit.
Yeah, I think it's got to be soft but not too dry. And they're all over the sand here, actually. All rushing around on the sand looking for a piece of kelp to eat. There's thousands of them here. It's amazing.
Ah, they're everywhere. They're on the camera as well. Some of them keep jumping on the camera.
Of course, not all the kelp that washes up on the seashore washes up on sandy beaches where it's accessible to the beach hoppers or amphipods. Some of it washes up on rocky shores, and on these rocky shores you have another garbage cleaner, and this is an isopod rather than an amphipod. So amphipods are small air-breathing crustaceans that are squashed side to side like a shrimp, and isopods are also air-breathing crustaceans but they're squashed dorsoventrally like woodlice.
Or like a cockroach, right?
More like a cockroach, that's right, yeah.
Yay, we're going to look
nice,
at cockroaches.
Nice, lovely little animals to handle. So we're going to try turning over some of this kelp on the rocks here and see if we can see some of these sea slaters, as they're called, these garbage man isopods.
Okay, they better not run into my shoes though. Okay, let's go.
There's some. Here they are.
Okay, they're not as bad as roaches.
So all isopods and amphipods are live bearers. So the females, this is a female, has a little pouch on her underside, and you can see those little yellow eggs are being held in the pouch. And the eggs will develop in the pouch into fully formed little isopods and then only get released when they're fully developed. So she has quite few young, maybe 50 to 100 eggs.
Oh, only 50 to 100.
So they breed up quite quickly, but compared with something like a mussel, let's say, which can lay 6 million eggs at a time, that's quite little. Okay. There's actually two different species of garbage cleaners here. There's this one with the flat back, and that's called the sea slater. It's very broad.
They're quite quick.
And then there's this spiky-backed one, and the spiky-backed one, the spikes are probably there to make them unattractive to predators, and they actually move a lot more slowly than the other one. So these are the little tortoises. Look at the hoppers!
Doesn't it irk you out just like touching all of these crawling?
No, I think it's great. You don't really want to have them like in your knickers, but